I'm KW.
I'm Max.
So what's your story? Why'd you come here?
Well, I'm an explorer, and I traveled a lot. And I traveled by sea.
Right.
I used to travel by air.
So obviously you have no home or family.
I have one of those, but...
But you ate them all?
No. No, I just bit one of them, that's all, and... went crazy. And I don't like frozen corn.
I'm sorry. That's why you left.
You act like I'm a bad person.
Well, are you?
I don't know.
Well, I'm glad you came. It'll be good to have someone around who doesn't eat everybody. I mean, you just bite everyone. But biters aren't so bad. Eaters are the ones I just can't stand.
I have no plans to eat anybody.
The typical way for Hollywood to make Maurice Sendak's book, Where the Wild Things Are, into a movie would be to turn it into Shrek. It would be noisy and colorful, the wild things would fart a lot, there'd be some stupid quest to save the island or some princess, one wild thing would be voiced by Chris Rock or Queen Latifah, and the movie would end with Max, the little boy, learning some saccharine lesson about friendship and being yourself. And it would utterly suck. Yet amazingly, director Spike Jonze was allowed to adapt the story his way, staying true to the book's tone of danger and rowdiness, while imbuing it with an unexpected and insanely clever emotional resonance that's made Where the Wild Things Are my favorite movie of the year so far, and maybe the best movie about childhood I've ever seen. The book's story is pretty simple. A bratty boy named Max is sent to his room with no supper for threatening to eat his parents. From there, he journeys to a far-off island where he meets a group of scary-looking monsters. Max becomes their king and leads them in wild rumpus until he decides it's time to go back home, where he finds his dinner, still hot, waiting for him. Jonze and co-writer Dave Eggers largely stick to the story, but fill it in with backstory and emotional reality. Max, played by terrific newcomer Max Records, is a lonely 9-year-old who can't find anyone to share his imaginative play world. Max's older sister, Claire, is too engrossed in her teenage life, and his divorced mom, played by Katherine Keener, is too busy with work and keeping the family together to give Max the attention he wants. We see that this is why Max acts out, as he struggles to deal with emotions like jealousy, frustration, and anger that he can't control and barely understands. After throwing a tantrum in front of his mom's date, Max runs out of the house, where he finds a boat and sails it to a somewhat bleak land and finds a group of large, sharp-toothed wild things. By showing that he's as wild as them and fibbing about having magical powers, Max is made their leader and essentially the sole parent of their family, whose task is to keep everyone happy and ward off bad feelings. In an interview, Jonze said his breakthrough in figuring out how to make the film was to see the wild things as wild emotions, and that to a kid, their own uncontrolled emotions and those of others can be frightening. This is the genius of the film, where the seven wild things not only represent different aspects of Max's emotions, but also those of his sister, his mom, and perhaps a projection of his absent father. By trying to deal with the monster's feelings of exclusion, frustration, and disappointment, which echo scenes from Max's own life, Max not only learns the challenges of dealing with his emotions, but begins to understand his mother and the impossible expectations he's placed on her. There's been a lot of discussion about whether this movie is too dark and the wild things too scary for little kids. But that's also what was said about the book when it was released in 1963. And it's vital in the movie that the monsters and their emotions sometimes be dangerous and scary, just as it can be terrifying for a kid when they lose their temper, or to watch a parent a kid relies on for stability to be gripped by anger, fear, or sadness. There's no hard and fast rule about what is and isn't scary for a kid to watch, so if there's a kid you'd like to take to this movie, you need to base it on what you think that specific kid can handle. But I think Where the Wild Things Are should be seen by people of all ages. We need to give kids more credit for understanding the imperfection of reality, that Max, like the wild things, and really all of us, has a good heart but can sometimes be selfish, inconsiderate, or hurtful, that it can be hard to figure out who you are, and that there are no magical kings or parents who can solve every problem, but that loving and trying to understand others is the best thing you can do. Jonze said that he never tried to make a movie for kids, but instead tried to capture what it feels like to be a kid, and in doing that, Jonze has made a classic that captures what it feels like to be all of us. I'm Jonathan Kim, and this is a ReThink Review.